state, and I represent the good people of Barkilladi and Riom. Mr. Speaker, I stand to support this motion, ably moved by the minority leader, and I want to align my thoughts with that of Honorable Luke. We are aware, Mr. Speaker, that this issue of insecurity is ravaging this country everywhere. And I want to agree that we should look at this matter holistically, incorporate the entire Nigerian society. However, coming to the motion on ground, Mr. Speaker, I wish to suggest that the National Assembly should have at least one gate that is strictly for only members and senators. The other gate should be for the staff of the National Assembly and perhaps, you know, visitors coming to the National Assembly. We have a high influx of visitors that have nothing to do in the National Assembly coming into the premises. Sometimes you will be sitting in your office, somebody will just run into your office, introduce himself or herself as having come to market a product. And I think we are not safe in these premises, Mr. Speaker. From the shared group, Mr. Speaker, from the count, it is clear by my own records, perhaps I'm wrong, that we've lost 7 precious lives of the citizens of this country as a result of this struggle. Yesterday, it was reported that 2 people lost their lives. The other time, it was 7. And if we continue this way, we'll continue to lose innocent lives, Mr. Speaker. I want to agree with what the submission of other speakers that, honestly, the federal government should obey, you know, the judgment of the court, because the danger is that in the event, God forbid, in the event that the leader of the Shiites, for whatever reason, you know, gives up the ghost, wherever he is kept, we are likely to have serious problems in this country. And that may lead to losing more lives. I want to plead with the federal government that you can release this leader and put surveillance, give him enough security to monitor his activities, rather than continue to keeping him wherever he is now, we don't know. But a court of competent jurisdiction has passed judgment that for whatever reason, this man should be released. Mr. Speaker, I think this House should perhaps advise the present government to, as a matter of urgency, to safeguard the lives of Nigeria, to release the leader of the Shiites, because we don't know the next step that the followers of Shiites will take. And we are looking at it as if it's just a child's play. We don't want a situation whereby more lives will be claimed as a result of this struggle. Thank you, Mr. Speaker, for giving me the opportunity to contribute.